so fast, and I'm using this much bow, and I cannot keep up with him. And I don't know how. They've got nowhere to go, and so I shake my fist at him in the middle. And I really, he loses me every time. So anyway, my job today is to tell you about a little bit. When he started talking about when he was 13 years old, I thought, how long is this program going to last? But I'm going to fast forward the tape a bit and talk about our professional careers. Of course, Lou's with the Air Force, and that's where I learned the music, along with David. And David is a chief master sergeant, is that right? In the Air Force, as was Lou. And that's less than 1% of the whole Air Force, so that's quite an achievement. And both Lou and David were in charge of the strings. So anyway, we've played literally thousands of private engagements, and one thing we did was work for the city of Atlanta to get the Olympics for America in 1996. And it started out with wearing Meridian House here in Washington.
Close enough.
So private parties, and I'll be as brief as possible, but the gentleman from Atlanta came up and the group caught his eye, and he said, you're our good luck charm, and he took us with him every step of the way. We went to Seoul and Barcelona, and it was a miracle. And the night of the...
Tokyo,
I forgot that, sorry. And the night of the Olympics when they opened in 1996, there was a red carpet. I wore a peach dress because Georgia peaches. The gentleman wore the white coats with the peach ties. I said, we're a long way from Kansas, Toto. And all these dignitaries came down the path, and it was just an extraordinary experience. And especially, Lou always wangles his way into anywhere he wants to go. And so he got press passes for us in the night they announced the Olympics winner in Tokyo. Because we had press badges and we were down there. And the other contestant close at hand was Athens, because it was the 100th year of the Olympics. So those first three letters, A, T, the next letter is the killer. So they went to announce, and the winner is at, they said Atlanta. We exploded. It was so thrilling. We were on tables. And so I said to Lou, quick, run, get your instrument. And we went to play, and all these photographers from all around the world were taking pictures, and we were having a wonderful time. That was a great one. Then the other was the National Airport, the new one. They had a dinner for all of the Senate and Congress. And I don't know how Ridgewell's cooked dinner for how many people were there, about 1,000 people? More like 5,000 people. it was amazing that he would play for the new airport. And the other one we want to tell you about is we're playing currently at the Gaylord Hotel. And that's that big complex called National Harbor. And we've been there, we're in our fifth year there, which is amazing. And we actually have the father of the gentleman who hired us here. Mr. Temple, would you stand up?
Yeah.
Really, that's Mark's dad.
I've also wanted to be an accordion player for a long time.
Yeah, well, seriously, it's so wonderful in this economy to work for a place. And his son and his mother right there too, lady in the yellow jacket. He's been a staunch supporter of ours, and how can you thank somebody enough for 5 years of employment at the hotel? I'm going to push for you to come, because we'd love to play for you there, and we'll get you a discount of 20%. So we stroll amongst the tables for, like Lou says, all the people eating. And the children are so often on the Game Boy and whatever else they're on, computers, and so I take my violin bow and bop them off. I have to first assess whether or not the parent is going to sue me. I usually can get it right, but then Lou sometimes will really give it to them. Anyway, I guess I have to play now, but it's been nice visiting with you, and it's been a pleasure, believe me, to play with my friend Luca Pola, David Swanson, and John for all these years.
Once a year we tune.
Thank you.
Thank you.